So my name is Mark Whitwell. I'm a yoga teacher. My teacher is Professor T. Krishnamacharya from Chennai, who died in 1989. He was 101 years old when he died. He was the teacher for some famous yoga teachers. Probably the most famous, BKS Iyengar, who's made yoga famous all over the world, and K. Pattabhi Joyce, the founder of this style of yoga called Ashtanga Vinyasa. The hallmark of Krishnamacharya's work is that there is a right yoga for every person, no matter who the person is. Unfortunately, this hasn't been taught in the world yet. Krishnamacharya's work has been curiously ignored as America popularized yoga and turned it into brands and styles and merchandised these systems. See? So my guru's statement, yoga, to be successful, must be adapted to the individual, not the individual adapted to the yoga. Is that quite clear what's being said there? Can you see in your life how you are continuously trying to adapt yourself to some sort of ideal that has been written or expressed somewhere, somehow, either in text or a DVD or a book, you know? Or even in your own mind creating idealism that you're trying, something that you're trying to be, right? Now, Krishnamacharya's great friend and my great friend, his name was U.G. Krishnamurti. You know, he used to come and stay here for 3 months at a time down in Palm Springs every year. And his dear friend Lisa is here, so Lisa can affirm this. Yuji, one of his lines was, human suffering is trying to be something that you're not. That is suffering. Can anybody own up to that? Thank you, sir. One honest man in the tent. Trying to be something that you're not, what, you know, even if that is the most sublime spiritual expression, you know, trying to be that sublime spiritual expression is your suffering. And Yuji used to say, there are no steps to be taken, therefore, right? You get that? How unimaginable in your life, in your spiritual improvement, there are no steps to be taken. Why? Because this extreme wonder and profundity of existence is already in us as us. Here we are. One teacher said, here is God, here. You know? Where is the question of getting to God? Who could come up with this body? Who? Who could come up with the upright spine and the heart beating and the breath moving and the sex moving, you know, this that is life, this extreme intelligence, this extreme wonder that is me and you. And the body as it is, you know, the flesh. He was always pointing out that you are the extreme intelligence of life. Already given, just as you are. You are the extreme function of reality itself, as you are. You are the extreme beauty of reality itself, just as you are. Without yoga, without meditation, without anything, right? Let's check. Is this the extreme intelligence of life sitting here, yes or no? Yay! Hallelujah! Is this the extreme function of reality itself lying there, yes or no? Thank you. Is this the extreme beauty of life lying there, yes or no? I rest my case. So where is the question of trying to be spiritual or trying to get somewhere? As if you're not somewhere already, the extreme intelligence, beauty, and function of reality itself. Ah. So doesn't that lift off a big weight? Who said yes? Did you feel it? Yay! Hallelujah. Then we have another question. If there is such a thing as an unseen source, an absolute reality, source condition to this extreme intelligence, beauty, and function here, can that source be absent from its appearance? Yes or no? Who said no first? Thank you, sir. You're on it. See, you are a non-dual tantrika, bhakta, shakti, yogi, participating in the already given wonder of reality itself that is appearing as this embodiment and this embodiment, right? Where is the question of getting somewhere? Yoga is not a question of getting anywhere. It is a matter of participation in the given. That's all it is. And he did come up with the great tradition. He was a scholar, you see, Krishnamacharya, and he came up with it. He said, here it is. This is what you do. And I'm going to teach you this today. And I'm going to ask you to practice it every day for 40 days, for the next 40 days, is your direct intimacy with reality itself, direct, without a mind of seeking for an alternative state, none of that. And guess what? Krishnamacharya is saying, and you cannot meditate. Meditation is also a hoax put on humanity of a subtle attempt to get somewhere. You know, it is your suffering. Trying to meditate creates a whole persona of someone seeking. Can you see that in your own life? Your attempt to meditate is creating a personality, a seeker, trying to get somewhere as if you're not somewhere. This movement to realize anything, let it dissolve, because you are the perfect wonder of reality, undeniably, even if you just think that through mathematically for yourself, just sit with it for a couple of minutes, you know, and let it do its work. He said, there is such a thing, of course, is meditation. Meditation is clarity of mind. It is to be at one with the object of your perception. It is to be at one with life. But you see, you already are at one with life. Is anyone here not at one with life? Yeah? Oh, cool. So the absorption has already occurred, you see. Then the attempt to do it just creates an obstruction to it. He said, it's like trying to put yourself to sleep. Trying to sleep prevents sleep. It creates a disturbance in the system trying to sleep. Trying to meditate creates a disturbance in the system. There must be an actual yoga, actual intimacy with the given reality. And this is what this asana pranayama is, you know, as he taught it. And we put the principles that he taught into all the popular styles and brands of yoga that have been developed in America over the last decade or two, you know. It needs to be there, and we put it in to turn it into the non-dual practice of direct intimacy with reality itself, that which is beating your heart and moving your breath and sex and putting the flowers on the trees, right, and the bees on the flower, and the wind through the trees, and the sun and the moon, the animal kingdom and the plant kingdom, that. The cosmos, the vast infinity of the cosmos has basically appeared as you, you know, hasn't it? You're here because everything else is here. Without the sun and moon, without Mother, Father, there would be no you. Without Mother Earth, there'd be no you. So, you know, so it's all just very obvious, straightforward, isn't it? Yeah. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Now, you know, my teacher's integrity, he'd say, there is no need for a teaching. No need. Because life is doing a perfect job on you right now. Could we just investigate that? You sitting there right now, you sitting there right now. Is life doing a perfect job on you? Yeah, it is, eh? You're in good hands in this universe. So he said, if a teaching is to arise, should it arise, it must be based on a sincere question from the student. Otherwise, just gossip. Go to the beach. Hang out. Have a cup of tea. Have a nice time. Don't subject humanity to teachings and idealisms when they're already the wonder of reality itself. Don't do that. You just confuse people. You give them desires that are false. The false desire for some state of other than what you are. So that being said, are there any questions? Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah. Thank you. You saved our bacon. Yeah. I think it's a perfectly good idea to find some quiet time, you know, please, you know, in the context of your yoga life. And what is yoga? Your intimacy with life, your intimacy with all ordinary conditions, starting with the body and breath. This is what I'm going to teach you. Then find some quiet time. Once intimacy with life has been established, Krishnamacharya's statement on this, the Buddha was a yogi, right? The Buddha appeared in yogic context, literally. You know, he was wandered in the plains of the Ganga in yogic culture. And he became, of course, at one with the natural state, with life itself. And he could perceive that there was no problem to existence, no problem to reality. But that's because he was intimate with the body and the body's relatedness to the natural conditions of reality, right? See, so this is why we say the primary spiritual responsibility is your intimacy with your own ordinary condition, your own embodiment, which of course is not ordinary. Who could come up with this? But God, but Source. So if God has come up with this, where is the question of seeking for God? You see, these false desires that are put in us to get to God is a denial of God. When God is appearing as this plain wonder, you know, that nobody can fathom. Nobody. Science can't. Not even touching it. What is life? You are that. So yoga is to be intimate with that which you are. The given condition. The ordinary life. And then, of course, one to another in that special polarity of the male-female power that is life itself. So I'd say you prioritize that practice in your life. I'd say actually and naturally, not obsessively. Then find a quiet spot. Right? In other words, find a nice life, you know. A nice room with some clear floorboards, not full of junk or dirty, you know. A little picture of your Ishta Guru, you know, the one you love specially, you know, who loves you. You know, nice little garden. Maybe the sound of water nearby or the wind in the, you know. This is what you're saying, right? But it just happens naturally, not as this intentional manipulation of mind that's been taught as meditation. You know, I'm sorry, not as this residing as witness only, which has been put on humanity, you know, a teacher teaching imposed on humanity that has actually created a dissociation and taken it off the intimacy. You know, residing as the witness to all conditions. You know that one? Eckhart Tolle and all that? There must be a yoga intimacy with all ordinary conditions for meditation to arise. Right. If you impose meditation before there is intimacy with all ordinary conditions, then you're just creating a mind fuck. Yeah. So be relieved of this necessity to get somewhere in your meditative idealism. That's what I'm saying. And embrace your life. UG said, this is making love to life. Inhale, exhale, strength receiving. The body loves its breath. The inhale loves the exhale. Male loves female in an exact mutuality, you know, utter surrender to. And you're practicing this in your own asana practice, this embodiment of the Shiva Shakti, right? If you do your asana correctly. But so far, sadly, it's not being taught. But you're getting it here. I kid you not, this is what Krishnamacharya, the teacher of Iyengar, taught. And I want you to know it and practice it. My little trick is start a 7-minute practice, do it every day, you know, for 40 days, and then see what happens. Meditation will arise in that context, guaranteed. Intimacy with all ordinary conditions, you know, you and me, intimate, will arise, guaranteed, if you're intimate with your own embodiment first. Last year we were here and Shamdas was here. He was alive in the body. His great friend and teacher, our beloved Shamdas, an extraordinary scholar of many things, especially the Vaishnava, the Krishna devotion, Radha Krishna. And he was a dear personal friend of mine. I loved him so much. We sat on stages together many times and I just loved him, you know, and he loved me. And I'm saying that mutual affection between two actual people is the universal means of religious life. It's in all systems, you know. You have an actual person that you have a friendship with, a trust. And so, you know, he, in his Vaishnava scholarship, said the same thing. His line was, the journey and the goal are the same. And what does that mean? So, you know, took that to heart. The journey and the goal are the same. The journey and the goal are the same. Then there's no goal. There's just the journey. There's just the life here. See, so there's the same thing. Everything dissolves. You're here now. You don't even have to be here now. You are here now. And this body loves, that's all. You love life. We love each other. We love Krishna, you know. Tears are falling for Krishna right now. It's not a future hope. It's to have your life. To have your cake and eat it too. Have your life, you know. Embrace your life. Yes, sir. That's right. These scholars, if they're integrity, they have integrity, they're not going to impose their scholarship on you. See, Krishnamacharya would literally say that. Do you have a question? Is there anything important for you? Is there anything that you need to discuss or you're going to die? You know, a burning question. So then, therefore, then we can discuss something. Otherwise, say, hallelujah, let's go to the beach. You know, let's enjoy the sun today, the literal light that is living us. You know. And you see, someone wrote a great book. It's called The Goddess and the Alphabet. As soon as man came up with written word, they destroyed the goddess by creating meaning and pathways to a future possibility. denying the wonder that is already living us, right? So this meaning is the problem. Always held by authority, you know, male authority, that apparently, according to the Mayan calendar, ended a few months back, you know. So now we can truly sit in our own ground, you know. And if there is any text, we can now just play with it. Have fun with it. But don't imagine that that the secrets of the universe aren't already utterly established in you. Where else are they? Are the secrets of the universe in this young woman here? Yes or no? Thank you. It's in her spine already. It's in her breath. It's in her relatedness. It is in her sex. Excuse me for raising that tricky subject. It is in the power of life that creates new life. You know, it is in motherhood, fatherhood that is created through the male-female union. I think we call that sex, right? Sex, the wonder of life, the power of being. It's our substance, you know, the male-female. And that's whether it's same-sex intimacy or opposite-sex intimacy, you know. So is that all right with you, sir? Are you happy to relinquish the texts and be a yogi? I like the idea of playing with them. Yeah, fair. Right. Yeah. Except the poetry can charm you and delude you too. You know. So there's the seduction of enlightenment. When you're already life itself, then trying to get enlightened is the denial of what you are, right? So as long as you've seen through that formula, you know? See, it's like when I say, you know, here is the extreme intelligence, beauty, and function of reality itself, this is not a spiritual statement, and it's not a poem either. It's like, it's not a roomy poem where we're like, whoa, that's so cool, yeah. No, it's just fact, you know? Take it to fact, take it to heart. Get serious about it. You are the extreme wonder, already given. Ah! So anything else, or should we just gossip? Oh, thank you. Thank you for thanking me. Yes, love. You tell them, please tell them to consider this, as I did with this young lady here. Just tell them, are you the extreme beauty of life already given? Are you the extreme intelligence? You know, that your hair can grow and the eyes can see, you know? Let them feel that through. And if somebody is so, you know, psychiatrically disturbed that they can't even think something through, fair enough, then please give them their yoga. Just get down to it, you know? Yeah, but you're asking a very beautiful question, because that's my question too, of how do I teach yoga in the world? How do I get it through? I want to get it through to all people everywhere. It's, you know, everywhere, including dreadful places where people are being killed and maimed and all that shit going down. Sir?
I feel like I just woke up about 90 days ago. The question is, now I'm aware of so many people that are awake. Is it just because I woke up, or are more people waking up?
Both. Yeah. Thank you. Now, please embrace your reality through a simple, actual, and natural, non-obsessive daily yoga practice. I'm going to give it to you. And I want you to test it out for 40 days. And I want you to promise me that you're going to do it. Thank you. Thank you. There's a great time-honored tradition. This, we meet, you know, I'm your friend, you're my friend, and we make an agreement, you know, to practice. Nothing exaggerated, nothing that's not suited to you. You know, it is your yoga that you can do. Not some struggle to do something that you can't do, some gymnastics or some spiritual gymnastics, you know, trying to meditate or something. You know, just what you can do. And in the tradition, it's there is this intervention between the teacher and the student, and you see the intelligence of what's being said, the logic of it. You test the practice out for yourself for 40 days, and you, I will do that. Thank you. And then you're very grateful to your teacher. There's a sincere friendship established there for the rest of life, you know. Yeah. But it's, yeah, it's still very dark times, though. So I hope you'll represent it, you know, till everybody gets it. Is there anything? Good. Yes.
So, as you're talking about, you know, practice that's available to us in classes and studios, and would you say that that's a hindrance or it takes us away from this?
I'm asking you to establish your own practice. Yoga is something that you do for yourself at home. And it's a very, you know, it's kind of a Western experiment with yoga is to bunch people in rooms, you know. And UG would say, yogis are not built on assembly lines. You can't do yoga in a bunch of people. You can have an experience, you know, like a gymnastic experience. You can get a buzz. You can strengthen the body, you know. You can get if you run a 4-minute mile, you'll get a buzz too, you know. If you run 10 minutes through the desert that way and 10 minutes back, you'll come, wow, that was great, you know. It's fair enough. Nothing wrong with that, you know. But I'm asking you to become a yogini. Practice. Hatha, strength receiving. Inhale, exhale, the union of the male-female polarities in your own system. Try that. And then bring that into relatedness with somebody else, a yoga relationship, a yogic intimacy with somebody else. Then the method of yoga is by participating in the union of opposites, we know the source of opposites. That's what I want you to do. That's what we're going to do. It's a very good question. You intuitively know this, don't you? You got to start practicing for yourself. Yeah. My teacher was the problem with Iyengar yoga, it's Mr. Iyengar's yoga. It's not your yoga. You know, we want you to do your yoga. Your direct intimacy with reality itself that is beating your heart and moving your breath and sex, putting flowers on the trees. That reality. Yeah. Sir. Totally. Totally. Yeah. To come into sangha, you know, into satsang, into groups, you know, but not to confine your yoga practice to that occasion. It implies, see, the sangha is those who are practicing, gather for kirtan. See? But it implies we're doing our sadhana. You're practicing direct intimacy with reality itself. You're doing your yoga. Yeah. Does that sit okay with you? See, you are involved in a sangha. You know, you might be in the Catholic Church, or you know, you might be in a bhakti group of bhaktas. You know, and that, fine, do your yoga, have your life. You know, have your cake and eat it too. Yeah. Yeah. But this is... When you do your practice, you can then realize the truth of the texts. The secrets of the universe are already in you as you, and you read it in the text, and the text just confirms what you've realized. Yeah, see, this actual practice, actual asana is so vital in the religious life. Because he said, if you don't have the practical means of yoga, the text makes you more miserable. Because you read these beautiful, inspiring ideas, but you have no means to realize them, to actualize them. So there must be the practice. And so then read the text, you know. But you see now how powerful the practice is, the strength receiving, inhale, exhale, the union of the male-female polarities in your own system is the catalyst which allows you to realize it in the outer polarity, and then he came along, right? The asana is a catalyst that allows you to realize all your potentials. It's a fact. So please do your asana. It allows you to realize your meditative potential, you know, which is your intimate potential. And it allows you to cut through this dysfunction that's been put on us of the male-female polarity, you know, that we're all suffering. You know? Aren't we? Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes, and that's what I was saying to this gentleman who's been enjoying so much, you know, waking up, so much liveliness, love, you know, as life itself. Beautiful, please, you know. And yet there is, in all, you know, not just in Palestine or Syria, LA, people are, you know, yeah, next door, or in your own family, right? Your own mother or your own, you know, so it's there, you see. So, you know, in the Buddhist tradition, Tibetan Buddhists, who I love very much, they're very serious people, you know, they have this concept of the ultimate meditation, the Vajra, you know, the Prajna Paramita, you know, that no object, no subject, no action, only reality. You and I are in the same bhav, reality itself. We are in love. We are in love. One condition, one reality. But they are very serious and great integrity. You cannot realize that. That comes as a grace. It's just given. That's the same thing as Krishnamacharya saying. It just comes, right? You do your sadhana, and the realization that there was only one condition just comes as a given. You can't make it happen, you know? Right. In the meantime, what you do is you do acts of compassion for all of life, including yourself, of course. And this asana that we do is the action of compassion. It is being kind to yourself. You know, it is making love to life to do a real yoga practice. Right? And then you be kind to everybody else. And in fact, the doing of the yoga gives you the capability of being compassionate to another. It's a beautiful thing, you see. The yamas and niyamas, asmita, not harmlessness, you know, comes as a siddhi, it comes as a result of your sadhana, your asana. You suddenly find that you do feel kindly towards yourself and towards others in a new way. You can't even be kind to another before you've been kind to yourself. So this is how important asana is. Be kind to yourself. It is the practical means. It is the practical action of metta, you know, of compassion in the Buddhist term. So that's what I'm, you know, as this world is full of suffering everywhere, be kind to yourself and develop kindness for others. Let everybody be your friend. Teach them yoga, inhale, exhale, or give them the other healing skill that you have, that God has given you. You know, you might be a herbalist or a doctor or a music teacher. Give them your skill. Be kind, you know. I think we have to accept that the suffering isn't going to go away this lifetime. Humanity seems to be getting worse, maybe, I don't know. You say it's the best of times, but it's the worst of times. But with the best of times and the internet and everything, you know, let's communicate yoga. That's what I want to do, is communicate yoga everywhere to the world. And so all people everywhere know that they are at one with their own reality. And reality is only a nurturing force, you know, that beats the heart and moves the breath and sex. It is motherhood itself, you know, it is Shakti. This that has appeared as her, as me, as you. You are that. That might come as profound heart feeling, bliss, realization at sometimes. In the meantime, anyway, do your yoga, the union of opposites in your own embodiment, within and without, is the life of yoga. And something will come through, you know, sometimes suddenly, you know, in a big burst of insight, and most often gradually, bit by bit, you know. Is that enough to go on? Can we go on, you know, with the dreadful circumstance we find ourselves in? Yeah, when people die, Shamdas died. It broke my heart. You know, fuck. Adidas Samraj said, if you could feel the human condition, it would be described as, this blissful body is wet with tears. See, this is what you're really saying, you know, the wound of love. To allow that too, you know, this important teaching, to allow pain. Pain is the healing. Yuji said that. Pain is healing. Took me a while to, you know, pain is Mother Nature. Pain is a nurturing force, actually, that is working in us, that is healing us. Looking after us, we change conditions. We take our hand out of the fire, you know, or we make adjustments when there's pain. So pain is not the enemy. It's to be relaxed into and honored, not fought against, not blindly trying to get rid of it through yoga and meditation and Prozac, you know, allowing it. Thank you so much. Is there anything else about anything else? Are there any other burning questions, issues that you will die if you don't get this resolved in the next 15 minutes? Sir? That's what I'm saying. Compassion. In my world, the act of asana is compassion. It is to engage the nurturing force of reality, you see, asana. It's a direct embrace of that nurturing that is life. I'd say you do that and then show it to others. You know, or use your God-given skills, whatever they are, to be kind to others. That's what we do in the meantime before the Prajnaparamita descends on us, you know, that there is only one reality. There is only God. There is only God. Comes to us by grace, not by willpower. have you been doing? Putting the principles of Krishnamacharya into all the brands and styles of yoga that you previously learned. Yeah, is that experiment going well? Loud voice. Have you found that using the breath as the gauge to the asana allows that for you? Yeah. Yeah. Let the breath, so statement for everybody, let the breath be the guru to your asana. Obey the breath. Yeah. Yeah, good. So that's going all right now. Your body's not hurting anymore. Oh, okay.
What was the second
We'll do that soon. I'll give it to you. Yeah. Could everybody? Could we all sit up? Thank you for a lovely little conversation, in the traditional way. You see. No teaching is required. The nurturing source of reality is always already arising as the extreme intelligence, beauty, and function that is you. There are no steps to be taken. I want you to know, my friends here, the yoga band, Ahalava. We're going to go on a college tour and educate young people and give them a learning on how to be intimate with life. In the midst of cramming their heads with academics, we're going to give them some skills in life. And there's very much Ahalava transmits the nurturing force in sound vibration. Can you try this, please? I want the sound vibration in your own body right now. Is it Om Shreem? Om Shreem, please. Om Shreem. Take a gentle inhale. And again, Om Shreem. Om Shreem. Gentle inhale. Shri Hai Namaha. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. You take a gentle inhale. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Gentle inhale. Namaha. Gentle inhale. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Would you inhale with the arms in a circle around the body? Come up, inhale. And then create a circle with that mantra. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, arms come up. Namaha. Inhale, come up. Om. One more time. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, and then bring your hands to the heart. Exhale. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Punaktu, Sahaviryam Karavhavahai, Tejasvinavadhi Tamastu Mavidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Again. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Om Gananam Tva Ganapatim Ganapati Gum Havamahe Gavin Gavinam Upamashravastamam Jistara Jam Brahmanam Brahmanaspata Anasrin Van Hoti Pishida Sadhanam Sri Maha Ganapataye Namaha Om. Please. Om Yogina Chittasya Padina Vacham Malam Sharirasya Chavajikena Yopa Karatam Pravaram Honi Nam Patanjalim Pranjali Ranatosmi Abahu Purushakaram Shankachakra Siddharanam Sahasra Sirasam Svetam Pranamami Patanjalim Srimate Anantaya Nagarajaya Namo Namaha. Om, please. Om. Sri Krishna Vagisha Yatishvarabhyam Samprapta Chakankana Basya Saram Sri Nut Narangendraya Tao Samapita Swam Sri Krishna Mayam Guru Varote Kartike Maste Shatata Udayam Yogacharyam Krishnamayam Guru Vayamaham Bhaje Sri Krishna Macharya Namaha Om. Please. Om. These initiating mantras to your practice are a blessing for your life that initiates your practice that starts today. Always from the great tradition from ancient time, these mantras given when yoga is transmitted. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Please. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Shanno Mitra Shambharunaha Shanno Bhavatvayama Shanna Indra Bruhaspatihi Shanno Vishnuraru Kramaha Namho Pramhasi Namaste Vayo Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Tvameva Pratyaksham Ritam Vadishami Satyam Vadishami Tanmama Vida Tadvaktarama Vida Avid Mam Avid Vaktaram. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Once more, please. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. again.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
There are no steps to be taken. Reality is always already on us, pressed up on us, looking after us, correcting and healing. Appearing as this extreme intelligence and beauty that is the ordinary condition, the ordinary life, the ordinary Buddha. Yay. May you stand up, please, and let me teach you the basics of the practice. Would you stand with your feet parallel and slightly apart? May I have a sip of water? Thank you. Would you do this really, really simple thing? I want you to inhale and bring the arms up. See the hands? And then exhale, bring the arms down again. Good. Inhale, bring the arms up. See the hands. Exhale, arms come down. It's so simple. A circle around the body. Inhale, come up. Look up, see the hands. Exhale, arms come down. Good. Inhale, arms come up, right up. See the arms above. Exhale, arms down. Good. Now look, everyone had a great exhale. I could hear it, the sound at the throat. Right, there's ocean breath. Same breath the body uses when it falls asleep. I want to hear that on the inhale, that sound. Could you just, first of all, sniff air through your nostrils? Just go. So it's not that. Take two fingers here, put them at the throat, make a little soft sound at the back of the throat on the inhale as well as the exhale. Inhale and exhale. Just hear it, please. Sound at the throat. Good. Now, with the arms, let's hear your inhale come up. And exhale. Listen to the exhale. Give me the same sound on the inhale at the throat. Carry on. Give me the same sound as you inhale. Ujjayi, it's called. Victory breath. Let this breath be sufficient. One more. Listen to your exhale. Hear that sound? Hear that sound? I want that sound on the inhale, not the nostrils. I want. Yes, he did it. Yay. Look up, soften it. Soften it a little bit. Soften. Drop the shoulders. Soft arms. Soft. Exhale. Yeah, good. A little faster. A little more flow to it. Inhale. Yeah, this is good. You're cooking. Now you're cooking. This man is cooking. Inhale up. Soft and receptive on the inhale. Strong on the exhale. All right, you're doing so well. I just want you to do a few more breaths. Just, you get this in your system. Good, sir. You hear that sound? I want that on. Soften it up. Don't stand like a soft arm. Inhale. Yes, good. And look up. Look up. Exhale. Good. One more. Good. That's it. Mouth closed. Yeah, just flowing with it. Just flowing. Great. Once more. Oh, this is much better. See? Just receptive, soft in the inhale. Yeah. Don't stand like a soldier at the end. When you get down here, soft arms.
Right. Good.
All right, thank you so much. And pause. One thing I often notice that people think they're doing, going to do yoga, they have to do something really major and hard, and they put a lot of effort into it, like, you know? No, see, should be no drama. Soft. Just please, again, inhale, come up. No drama on the inhale. And exhale. Good. Beautiful. Now, next instruction. Please make the breath envelop the movement. If this is the body movement, this is the breath movement. The breath starts the movement and ends the movement, right? Please try. Inhale, come up. Right up. See the hands. Now start the exhale before you move. Good. Start the inhale before you move. And you're still inhaling when the hands come together at the top. And carry on. Not too slow, please. You're just having a good breathe. You're in life, breathing life. No need to get spiritual. Have a good breathe. The body loves its breath. The exhale loves the inhale. Om Shreem Shri Hait Namaha. Two more breaths. The breath enveloping the movement. One more. All right, great. Thank you. And a little pause. Right, now here comes a big test, because now you're going to do some stronger asana, okay? And I want to hear your receptivity, feminine. Inhale, come up. Inhale. Right up. Exhale, forward bend, go down. Deeply down. Soften the knees and the neck. Pause. Inhale, the arms bring you up again. Let me hear your ujjayi inhale. Up you come. In a circle around the body. Right up. Good. Exhale, go down. Pause out after exhale. Soften the knees and the neck. Arms bring you up, inhale. Excellent, sir. Let the breath start and end the movement. Carry on. You're doing great. Let the movement be all about breath. Remember I said obey your breath, obey the guru. The body movement is the breath movement. The breath starts and ends the movement. Keep weight through the front of the feet, the toes active. All right, now stay down in the forward bend for four breaths in the same breath ratio that you established in the movement. On inhale, ease the forward bend. On exhale, deepen the forward bend. You can create a nice relationship with your toes and your fingertips, some any kind of relatedness, acknowledging they're on the same energy body. Beautiful. On your next inhale, come on up. Arms bring you up. Right up. Right up. And then hands to your heart. The hridaya, the heart, the place where the inhale and the exhale meet. Where strength is receiving, the heart. Good. Come to the front of your mat. Inhale, arch, come up. Inhale. Start the exhale before you move. Forward bend, go down, deeply down. Stride one leg back, 3.5 feet. A good strong stride, the back foot flat and comfortable. Diagonal to the forward direction. Inhale, come on up. Inhale up. See the arms above. Right up. Exhale, deep forward bend, come down. Abdominals lift in and up. It's called bunda. Pause. Inhale, come up again. The arms bring you up. Keep equal weight through the front of each foot. Exhale, come down. Abdominals lift in. It's called bunda. Pause in the bunda. Arms bring you up. Inhale. Right up. Two or three more breaths. Beautiful. Stay with it. You're just pumping above to below. No struggle. Just the breath moving. The breath is moving the body. All right, on your next inhale, stay up there for four breaths. Bring the hands softly together, the shoulders soft, the elbows soft. See the hands. It'll strengthen the back arch. Be comfortable in the arms where you can see the hands, equal weight through both feet, and do this strength receiving, hatha yoga, inhale, exhale. Let me hear your inhale. Let me hear the ujjayi into the upper chest. The inhale is into the upper chest. The exhale is from the body base. Good, you're doing great. Once more, inhale. On your next exhale, forward bend, come down, deeply down. Pause, soften the neck, stride forward in the bunda with the breath held out. Stride forward, come forward. Stay one inhale, one exhale, and inhale, come on up. Arms bring you up, right up. And hands to your heart, exhale. All right, you did great. What you will do at home, right? Inhale, come up, right up. Deep exhale, forward bend, come down. And pause, stride the other leg back 3.5 feet. Inhale, arch, come up, right up. Arms bring you up in a circle. See the hands, start the exhale before you move. Four breaths moving. Good, pump it. Your own yoga. Your own breath. Your intimacy with life. Making love with life. Strength receiving. All right, on your next inhale, stay up for four breaths in the same breath ratio that you established in the movement. Let me hear your inhale. Equal weight through both feet. No struggle in the body at all. Good. All right, on your next exhale, forward bend, come down. Deeply down, abdominals in and up. Stride together, stay one inhale, one exhale, and inhale, arms bring you up, right up, see the hands, exhale, bring the hands to your heart, the heart, the heart, the place where all opposites arise, the seat of the mind. Let me see it again, please. Inhale, arch. Right up, exhale, forward bend, stride one leg back, inhale, Virabhadrasana, up you come, move your arms in a circle, very natural, exhale, forward bend, good, abdominals lift in and up, inhale, come up, pause, deep exhale, forward bend, inhale, come on up. Thank you. Now stay two breaths in the stationary asana in the same breath ratio that you established in the movement. Good. Next exhale, forward bend, come down. Deeply down. Pause. Stride together. Stay one inhale. One exhale. Stride the other leg back 3.5 feet. Inhale, come up. Virabhadrasana. Just flow. Just pump. Above to below. Exhale down. And carry on. One more inhale and stay two breaths. You're doing great. And next exhale, forward bend down, deeply down, pause, stride together. Stay one inhale, one exhale. And inhale, come on up. Arms bring you up. Thank you. Please. In the silence. just observe your natural breath now, standing, resting. In asana, we allow the heartbeat and breath to return to normal after each asana. It's an important aspect of the practice. All right, inhale, come up, right up. Exhale, forward bend. Walk both feet back into this down dog position, Ardha Mukha Svanasana. Now immediately inhale into cat pose. Bring the knees to the floor, arch, look up, right up. Exhale, child pose. Good. Inhale into cat, arch, come up. Exhale, down dog. Abdominals lift in and up. Inhale into the upper chest into cat. Exhale into child pose. Good. Inhale into cat pose. Chakravakasana. Exhale, down dog. Inhale into cat. Exhale, child pose. This is how simple it is. And rest, complete rest. Give up and give over to the floor. Elbows down. And just sink into the floor. Inhale, stand on the knees, bring your arms up to the sky, right up, inhale. Good. Exhale, back to child pose. Inhale, come through to Bhujangasana, abdominal to the floor into this back arch, right through. Inhale. Exhale, stay, make the belly work, no weight through the hands. Inhale, stay, and exhale, child pose, all the way back. Good. Inhale, arms to the roof, come up. Good. Start the exhale before you move. Child pose. Pause. Inhale into cobra. Come right through. Strong exhale. Stay. Feel the belly working. Inhale. Stay. Exhale. Press the knees on the floor. Come back into child pose. All the way back. And pause. Inhale. Arms to the sky. Come up. Good. Yay. Exhale. Child pose. Inhale, come through to cobra. Strong exhale, stay. Inhale, stay. Exhale, child pose, come back. Inhale, stand on the knees. Exhale, hands to your heart. Right, you got that? Can you take that home? Do it every day? Good, thanks. Let me see if you've got it. Inhale up. Start the exhale before you move. Child pose. Inhale, cobra. Strong exhale. The belly's on the floor. No weight through the hands. Exhale, child pose. Inhale, arms to the roof. Come up. Hands to the hridaya, the heart. The seat of mind, the heart. The first cell of life that was created when you were created, the heart. See, that's now blooming as the whole body. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha, please. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, arms up. Child pose with that mantra. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, cobra. Now, strong mantra. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Beautiful. Inhale, stay. Exhale, mantra. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Very powerful. Inhale. Child pose mantra. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, stand on the knees. Hands to the heart. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, arms up. Child pose mantra. Om Shri Shri Hai Namaha. Inhale, cobra. exhale mantra. Om Shri Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, mantra, head to the floor. Om Shri Shri Hai. Good, now put the arms out in front of your head and just lie there and have a rest. Full frustration. Just have a rest and let the music go for you. Let the music vibrate through the spine. Receive it. Panidana Tapaha Swajaya Ishvara Pranidana Kriya Yogaha. The surrender of the body to its own reality. The pranas in your spine is the same prana as the universe, of course. So you acknowledge that. Give that over. Pranidana. Dana to give your prana. To Ishvara, Ishvara Pranidana. Good, and please roll over onto your back and hold the knees. Thank you. One hand on each knee. On inhale, feet to the roof, arms over the head to the floor behind the head. Inhale. Let me hear your inhale. Exhale, hold the knees, bring the knees into the chest. And pull, hold the knees. Inhale, feet to the roof, arms over the head. Exhale, hold the knees. And carry on. Inhale, come up, right up. Receive the inhale. Exhale, hold the knees. Once more, inhale, come up. Arms right over. Exhale, hold the knees. The body movement is the breath movement. Once more. Inhale, come up. Arms over. All right. Once more, inhale up. Exhale, hold the knees. Good, and rest. Thank you, just rest. All right, hold the knees on your next inhale, feet to the floor, lift the back off the floor and inhale. Arms over, arms right over, lift up. Exhale, come down, hold the knees. Push the breath out. Good. Inhale, come up, arch the back as much as possible. Pause after inhale, exhale, come down, hold the knees. All right, above to below, keep going. Inhale, come up. Exhale, hold the knees. One more time. And stay. Inhale, come up and stay up for four breaths. Do that work. Lengthen the pause after inhale. Let me hear the inhale. And exhale, come down, hold the knees. Tell you that this asana that you're in now, of course, is an inversion, the limbs above the trunk. It's very helpful. please teach your family to rest like this. A little bit of breathing and then resting with the limbs up like this is deeply restorative to the heart, to the cardiovascular. Please teach everybody, your mother, your father, your grandmother, your grandfather, your children, how to rest, how to relax in life. A little bit of breathing like we did, then the limbs up like this. Good. Would you please now stretch out and continue to rest a bit longer? And I want you to put the heel of the hands into your eye socket, please. Let your body receive the vibration. Please rest each leg in the whole body. Rest each toe in the foot. Rest the whole head in the whole body. Be the whole body at rest, whatever the whole body is altogether. We already discussed that. The whole body is reality itself. Please wait till you can notice that the whole body is arising in stillness. Everything is arising in stillness. You might notice there's a kind of power in that stillness, a kind of strength. Please notice that reality is pressed up on you. something is living you, looking after you, healing you. This mystery is in every cell. It is an extreme intelligence. You always have this. You can't lose it. There's no getting it. You don't have to get it. You don't have to look for it. You don't have to find it. It is arising as your own reality, moment by moment. It is completely nurturing. It is completely regenerative. It wants your long and happy life. It is complete love, the unitary factor of all life. No one needs to give this to you, and no one can take it away from you. Shreem Hreem Kleem Mahalakshmaye Namaha. Om Shreem Hreem Kleem Mahalakshmaye Namaha. Om Shreem Hreem Kleem Mahalakshmaye Namaha. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Om Shreem Hreem Kleem Mahalakshmaye 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 Namaha. Mahalakshmaye Namaha. Om Shreem Hreem Kleem 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 Ganapatim, Ganapati Gum Havamahe Kavim Kavinam Upamashravastamam Jaistarajam Brahmanam Brahmanaspatahanas Shunvan Hutivishida Sadhanam Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha. Om Sri Mahaganapataye Namaha. Thank you. Good. Would you please gently transition to a sitting asana and continue to rest sitting just for a moment. Just do what you were doing, sitting, doing it, just resting. See if you can find that same equanimity. Resting, sitting, as the whole body. Just resting. Not looking, not requiring, not meditating. Do a really simple thing. Inhale, bring the arms up. Inhale. Exhale, circle around the body. Inhale, circle, come up. Circle, circle. Strong exhale from the base. Good. Carry on. Inhale, circle, come up. Pause. Exhale, circle. Thank you. Just pause for a moment. I want you to consider one thing. This brilliance that we have fueling Mother Earth, the sun, and the literal light that is penetrating you right now. I want you to acknowledge the fact that you are made of light. Without this light, without the delicate wonder of photosynthesis, there would be no life. Life is light, literal light. It is living you right now. Please let this light have its way with you. Takes care of everything. Every disturbance. Vanishes.
Gone.
In the light. Inhale, bring the arms up, receive this light, inhale, and give this mantra to the sun. Om Shri, Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, receive the light. Arms come down, give that mantra to the sun. Om Shri, Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, receive the light. Give that mantra to the sun. Om Shri Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, receive the light. Arms come down. Om. Inhale, receive the light. Leave your arms in the air and give that mantra to the sun. Om Shri. Inhale, be with the light. Arms come down, give the mantra. Om Shri Inhale, receive the light. Give that mantra to the sun. Om Shri Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, receive the light. Arms come down. Om Shri Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, receive the literal light. Inhale. Om Shri Shri Hai Namah. Inhale, receive the light. Bring the hands to the heart this time. Om. Could you make your hands quite soft at the heart? The cave in the hands, associated with the cave in the heart. Would you visualize, please, the eight-petaled lotus that blooms from the heart? Please see the petal and the crown. Petal and the base. Petal on the left side, one petal on the right side. In the diagonals of the body, please see the tips of each petal, how it might turn back towards the heart. This anciently given form of nurturing source, reality itself, that appears as everything. The Padma Hridaya, the seat of Mother. Shreem Shri Hai Namaha, please. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Put that into the upper petal. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Put it into the lower petal. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Put it into the left petal. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. The right petal. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. The left upper diagonal. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. The right lower diagonal. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. The right upper diagonal. Om Shreem. The left lower diagonal. See the whole lotus bloom. This floral intelligence and beauty and function that we know so well. Relaxed, searchless beholding. Shimmering. Flow of nurturing from the Hrid, from the heart, that is always there for you under all conditions. The source has become seen through the heart. The source is appearing, the prana is flowing. You are loved, you are nurtured, cared for, and you love, and you care. This is the substance of reality. This is life. This is safety. If you can take this mantra home with you, it's given to me by my teachers, I give it to you, given to them by their teachers from the great tradition, the ancient flow of nurturing to this moment. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha, please. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namah. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. Om Shreem Shri Hai Namaha. So much, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. May this go out from here to
all of life. May this not be an isolated little event here. May we teach the people everywhere. There's practical means of how to be intimate with our own reality. When everybody everywhere can be intimate with their own life, there'll be peace. There must be a practical means. The breath has been given to us in this wisdom tradition. Be with your breath. Be with your breath, then you're with God. That which breathes us, you see, that which lives us. Do this simple, practical thing. And may it go into the Middle East. We have a non-profit foundation called the Heart of Yoga. We teach people in all these sad places, and they're feeling their life again, you know, at a grassroots level. Peace is breaking out, you know. Please support that if you can. Heart of Yoga Foundation. We train these people in the Middle East and elsewhere. We need that to happen. It needs to flow quickly. May everyone receive this soon. Everyone everywhere.